Ladies and gentlemen and ninjas, welcome back to the African Geekdom. It is I and I, Yaman JP. First off, I'd like to thank you for clicking on my face. I appreciate the time you spend with me here on this channel. And thank you for the new subscribers I have. Hope to get more. On that note, please like and subscribe. Today, we're here to review Ruroni Kenshin, The Beginning. Was it Ruroni Kenshin, The Final, Part 2, The Beginning. However convoluted the title might be. Modafoka. That was the shit. Right up front, no bullshit. Let's get into it.
あなただけは絶対に切りをしない。今のあなたには狂気を抑える鞘が必要です。十字傷に秘められた謎がついに明らかになる。 Ruroni Kenshin 最終章 The Beginning.
So, grab your coffees. Ruroni Kenshin, The Beginning. What do I think of it? First off, preface this. I grew up. Yeah, I was in school when it was playing Samurai X, I believe the anime was called. Yeah, and upon watching this one, I had just heard, or this actually came out last year, Ruroni Kenshin, The Beginning. But its precursor, part one of this two-part movie saga, was Ruroni Kenshin, The Final, part one, which I guess, to make sense, it was the last one. Okay, it was the last part of the story that came first. And this is the prequel to the whole five movie arc, which is the last movie. Am I making sense? And I just watched the first one, the first part, which is the last part of the story with the last antagonist is going to face. And I was kind of pissed when I found out that the next one that's coming out, which is going to be the last movie, this one, The Beginning, was the prequel to everything. So I didn't fucking bother. Now, what the fuck is this? Y'all got me fucked up. because I didn't see how they could top the Ruroni Kenshin in the final. You get me? That final fight sequence with the main antagonist, Enishi. That, honestly, it's worth your time just for that extraordinary final battle. The choreography, top-notch. But we're not here to review that one. Now back to what I was saying. I grew up watching this. And after skipping out on Ruroni Kenshin in the beginning, around, is it a month or 2 months ago? I happened upon the news that they were going to reboot the anime. And it starts playing next year. And they're going to do the complete arc this time. Because the original anime run, it didn't finish, ended on a filler, I think 90 episodes in. We never got the completion of the manga in anime form. Now we will next year, starting from the very first volume, which sounds great. So I said, okay, might as well finish this last movie. And boy, did I eat fucking crow on this one. I loved every minute of it. This might be the greatest live action adaptation of a manga slash anime ever put to screen. Maybe it might sound like hyperbole, but the movie is that good that it transcends its original formats. Yeah, And you can tell that since 2012, with the first Ruroni Kenshin movie, it's been the same director and the same lead. The director being Keishi, let me not butcher it, Keishi Otomo, and the actor playing Kenshin Himura is let me check, Takeru Sato, and he's obviously grown into this role. And I don't know what his man is drinking. He hasn't aged a day, just saying. While I was initially skeptical about this movie, it fucking wowed me. And the main story, and you would think that it's a silly premise, because this prequel is mostly about how Kenshin got his signature X scar, the cross scar, across his cheek. It's the origin of a fucking scar. You could lump that right up there with the Star Wars Rogue One. And yeah, is there something about these superficial plot holes or this like Rogue One, if you think about it, it's just about that exhaust port. But oh wow, one missile blew up the Death Star because they couldn't detect it. So somebody made a whole movie about why the Death Star had that weakness, and we got basically what might be the greatest and the best Star Wars movie to date. Yeah, and probably better than the Empire Strikes Back of the original trilogy. And with Kenshin, Ruroni Kenshin, the best of all the Ruroni Kenshin movie is not one. There's plenty of character. There's more character development in this one than you would expect about a movie just about oh how he got scarred. Am I making any sense? So just this, and it's a whole 2 hour movie. It's a lot of movie, and it's a damn good movie. The fight sequences are the most visceral they have ever been in this franchise. A lot less, even a lot less stylistic than, and a lot less choreographed than the final fight in Ruroni Kenshin, the final part one. I watched the dub version and seamless. Might also be the best dub anything ever. This was a damn good time. It's on Netflix actually. All five of the Ruroni Kenshin movies are on Netflix. Get into them. But my advice is to start with part one. No, start with part two, the beginning, and then go to part one, the ending. Because the fight of part one, the final, while great, didn't have that much of an emotional impact because you got flashbacks of what happened. So, Enishi's plight, while you got that he felt justified, you didn't really feel the emotional impact of the fight. But if you watch part two, the beginning first, then there's a lot that happens that sets up that fight, fam. I don't know why this movie came out last. But I suppose you never really know what you got until you get the final product. They probably thought that, as I said, a movie about a scar would be superficial. We'll release that the last one. We don't want to ruin the one with the main fight thing, the one we had the most action invested in it. Not that it's this one, part two, the beginning, is just a better movie. It actually heightens the quality of part one, the final. Are you following me here? So if you're gonna watch it in any watch order, I would say watch part two, the beginning, and then watch part one, the final, and then you can watch all three of the mainline Kenshin trilogy, so to speak. As for my score, I loved this movie. I will give it the very rare 10 out of 10 reels. I was emotionally invested. It was beautiful to watch, lots of grays, but beautiful set pieces, yeah, beautiful practical sets, barely any CGI, great acting, great visceral action, and a very strong character development. So yeah, I'm gonna give this a 10 out of 10. 10 out of 10 reels, free reel fam. And on my Shaggy scale, I will give this, of course, a Mr. Bombastic.
Mr. Bombastic!
So watch these two back to back. Watch these two movies back to back. Of course, start with part two, then go to part one. It's definitely worth your time. So, till next time, this is me, your main man, JP on the African Geekdom. Don't forget to like, subscribe. Thank you for spending your time with me. And until next time, the force be with you. Live long and prosper. May the odds be ever in your favor. Wakanda forever, my ninjas. I'll catch y'all on the next one.